Let's see how to set up and use Smartproxy proxy servers. Once you're on Smartproxy's dashboard, head to your chosen product tab. No matter which proxy type you use, proxy setup starts with authentication. All residential, mobile, ISP, and data center proxies can be authenticated with credentials. Here you can create, edit, and copy your usernames and passwords. Another authentication method is IP whitelisting, available for residential, mobile, ISP, and data center pay per IP proxies. For this method, you can either automatically add your current IP address or enter it manually. Just make sure you're not using a VPN or proxy service at the time. Next step is the endpoint generator. Based on your proxy type, you can choose your user, proxy location, session type, and protocol settings. Once you're satisfied, copy one of the endpoints or save an entire list to your clipboard. You may also export it as a CSV or a TXT file. If you choose username password authentication, you'll notice your credentials have already been included in the endpoint. Apply the endpoint to any application or third-party tool to use proxies immediately. Alternatively, check out proxy integration code examples in various programming languages. Copy the code snippets and add them directly to your script. Need to track your statistics? For all plans except dedicated data center proxies, you can check traffic usage over a chosen period. You'll also be able to see your top 10 targets or filter the data by user. That's all you need to know to start using Smartproxy proxies. Try our service yourself with the link in the description. For more information on how to use or integrate Smartproxy products, visit our YouTube channel and documentation.